The strangest elements found in the Earth's crust. Do you remember that periodic table in your chemistry class? No? Neither do I. But there are some strange elements that you didn't even know existed, and I'll show you right now. They'll blow your mind!
It is fascinating, really.
Rhodium. This element has a lot to do with platinum, as it is found in mines. That's why 80% of rhodium's production is in South Africa. This element is used to galvanize that silver ring you'd like to buy. Rhodium usage is also applied in the automotive market. Can you imagine to have an engine covered with plating? It's the most expensive metal in the world, since just 1 ounce of 28 grams might cost you $8,000. Much more than gold. Bromine. With atomic number 35, this is bromine. It used to be called liquid fire, as it's reddish and corrosive to human tissues. Its name comes from the Greek bromos, which means odor or stink. The vapor irritates eyes and throat a lot. Bromine is a non-metal liquid colored brownish red. It's used as a purifying solution, solvents to make pharmaceuticals, and more. A stinky element, but very useful. Astatine. This element is very strange and only available in tiny quantities. It can't even be observed. Fun fact, its name, that comes from the Greek astatos, means unstable. And it sure is. Don't believe me? The astatine is a radioactive halogen with atomic number 85 and a short half-life, almost as long as an 8-hour shift. The total amount of astatine in the Earth's crust is less than 28 grams. What's interesting is that it'll be used in new treatments for cancer. Berkelium. Metallic, radioactive, and synthetic. The berkelium, with atomic number 97, was discovered in 1949 at the University of California, Berkeley, USA, and named after that city. This element has been totally produced in the United States since 1967 up to now. It weighs a little more than 1 gram. There's no practical use of berkelium, and it is of scientific research interest only. It has a half-life of less than a year, and by getting disintegrated, it creates the californium-249, which is a very powerful and harmful emitter of alpha particles. Protactinium. It's a radioactive metal with a short half-life and atomic number 91. Its name comes from the Greek protos, meaning first. Silvery and malleable, but with no uses for it outside of scientific research. Protactinium occurs by the disintegration of uranium and thorium. It's harmful only if you eat it or inhale it. As this is not a common element, it's extremely expensive and valuable. In 1961 in the United Kingdom, 125 grams of 99.9% pure protactinium was produced by processing 60 tons of radioactive waste. This has been the only source of the mineral for years, costing up to $2,800 per gram, which currently would be around $23,000. Iridium. It's a very corrosion-resistant element, dense but brittle and silvery white. With atomic number 77, iridium belongs to the platinum family. It was named after Iris, the goddess of the rainbow, due to the different colors in its salts. Only about 3 tons of iridium is extracted every year. When pure, it is brittle and not possible to work with. Iridium is one of the densest elements on the planet. It's really hard to find in the Earth's crust, but it's very common to find iridium in meteorites. Cesium. Cesium is a soft metal which is usually liquid at room temperature, as its melting point is 83.3 degrees Fahrenheit. It's a very reactive metal, reacting explosively upon contact with water, and it doesn't get along with air either. The cesium is rare in nature, and to get it, the molten halide electrolysis or molten metal distillation will be necessary. Rubidium. It's a metallic element of the alkali group, silvery, shiny, and highly reactive. Rubidium might burn in the air with a yellowish-violet flame. That's very strange, isn't it? On the other hand, it reacts violently with water. It gets alloyed with gold and other alkaline metals. The rubidium is used in ion engines for space vehicles and telecoms. There's not much of it, and the minerals are only composed of up to 3% of rubidium. Copernicium. An element with a really short half-life. Copernicium is completely synthetic and radioactive. It was discovered a few years ago, and only in 2010, the International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry recognized its official name in honor of Nicolaus Copernicus. It's used only for scientific research, has atomic number 112, and there's no info about what it looks like. The only known version of it has a half-life of 0.24 milliseconds. In other words, it disintegrates instantly without a trace. Gallium. It's a soft metal. Liquid gallium is grayish and solid gallium is bright silver. It melts at a low temperature. It can be solid in your hand and it can get melted like chocolate. Gallium was named after France, as this country used to be named Gallia at the time of the Roman Empire. It melts easily, but only at 2,200 degrees, it turns into vapor. It's used for microwave circuits, solar panels, blue and violet LEDs. Also, it's very likely to be in your thermometer. This world is full of unusual surprises, don't you think? If you liked all these elements as much as I did, don't forget to like the video and subscribe for more interesting content. See ya!